Welcome to the introduction to the AutoRay 2 cradle for the multi-ray device. This happens to be just the cradle section. You can also get a controller. There are exhaust gas ports, gas port 1, gas port 2 for our different gas types, so we can go up to a 5 gas instrument. As USB communications to communicate with the PC. We also have options, if we unlock this section, to have multiple cradles logged together in a larger control panel system. So in this particular instance, I'm going to apply a can of calibration gas to exhaust port 1, which is set up for a 4 gas mix. We can see I would use a standard and on-demand regulator with one of these systems. To get the unit into calibration mode, we can input the unit in a switched off position, or if we go operationally, as you'll see in the multi-ray video, in a slightly different video, we can put it into AutoRay 2 communications mode. So this is now going to start up the instrument and it will warm up. So when it's giving the two orange lights, it's just warming the instrument up and starting things in operation. At the end of that period, it's a simple press to bump or press to calibrate. This happens to be a 2 gas multi-ray, so it's set up purely for LEL and oxygen. So using a standard 4 gas mix here, I can calibrate the unit. This has a hydrophobic built in as standard, just to make sure of no contaminants going out. You can exhaust out to a clean atmosphere if you're in a small area and have a large control based system. This just means you can exhaust out to a extract. So now we have the two green lights on the device, so this gives us an opportunity to either bump or calibrate. It is important, there can sometimes be a slight delay on response. It's press and hold for a single bump and then it will go for a bump test on the instrument. So we can now see that is now performing a bump test on the instrument. Depending on how the controller is set up, if the unit fails the bump test, it can then go into automatically into a full calibration cycle, but in this case we're just going to perform a bump test. If the light goes green at the end of it, we know it's been a successful bump test. If it goes to red, it will either automatically go into a calibration cycle, or it will you'll have to manually calibrate the device. So we can see that that bump test has been successful. I'm now getting a message from the instrument, and if we want to see any of the gas values, so if we were, for example, to have had a fail, if we open up by de-clipping and uncoupling the device. Alternatively, you can go and visit our website at www.safetymonitors.co.uk or do give us a call on 01489 890 458 between 9 and 5 Monday to Friday, or outside of normal working hours, please do give us a call on 07951 854 824. We're here when you need us, and we understand that the normal 9 to 5 day doesn't always apply. So please do feel free to give us a call. Thanks for visiting, and we hope to see you again soon.